Hi, in this video about Infinite Galaxy, I want to talk a bit about the research center and the research categories and going into the different ways to speed up your research speed. In my research, you can use it to improve various various aspects of your account. And in my eyes, research is very important, arguably more important than upgrading your buildings. But of course, you need to upgrade your buildings first, including your command center, followed by a research center before you can unlock new research projects and research project levels. But anyway, when you look at speeding things up, I think there's a lot more research to be done than buildings to be built, at least at the level where I'm at. So it's good to keep a big focus on speeding up your research and, of course, always have research going. So first we are going to have a look at the different trees. For the resources tree, this is, in my eyes, a very important one. Well, they're all important, but this resources are, in my experience, a very big issue in the game. So spending some effort into upgrading the projects, researching the projects that speed up your resource gathering is definitely going to be very useful. So for all the four different resource types, you have projects that, let's look at Titanium, that you have projects that increase the general gathering rate. Except for the general resource gathering for titanium, for the rest, the general resource gathering and the planet resource gathering of all resource types you have to unlock here. So for example, the unlocking the planet titanium gathering. And we have an increasing the planet titanium steel output with a fixed amount. That is useful, but not as useful in my eyes as the percentage-wise, because you're getting an extra percentage over what you already get, especially if you get on higher level nodes, is going to be very useful as well. There are a couple of other projects. The load boost, I think, still useful, but not as useful as increasing the gathering rate. The storage center capacity, useful, especially if you're going to be in a lot of war, if you're going to be attacked a lot, it saves more of your resources or keeps more of your resources safe. But if you are not really in an aggressive galaxy, then maybe this is also something you can wait with a bit while you first focus on increasing all the resource gathering. Basically, everything is useful for the resource gathering. But if you, for example, like me, say, well, I'm always doing the titanium, I'm always doing that on the planets, and deuterium I'm never going to do on the planets because that is currently just very much lower, it might make sense to focus with titanium more on the planet gathering ones and with deuterium more on the normal gathering, the regular gathering. I haven't really followed that through, but that is something, if you want to put some focus, that is something you could consider. Okay, going to the next tree. Development actually contains a large variety of projects that all have their use. The modelized construction and cloud computing, they improve the spaceport construction speed and the research speed, especially the cloud computing. I still have to do one level, but of the first project, there are other projects further down the line. Those are definitely going to be very useful because you keep doing research. There are certain functionality that you're going to unlock. Spaceport teleport is quite important, or very important in my eyes. And in general, all those, there's only one level, definitely do those. You have to do those as well to get further, but they give some nice benefits. Then there are a couple of other ones like the expand dock that increases the building queue leadership. so you can build more spaceships at the same time. That is going to be helpful early on in the game. And the spaceship production line is going to increase the speed with which you will build spaceships, warships, sorry. That is going to be, that is also useful, but especially once you have bigger, unlocked bigger warships, and we will go into that in the next section, then the increase of speed is going to be more useful. If you still have quite short building queues, it's probably more important to increase the building queue than increase the speed. Depending, of course, on if you are online 24/7, then you can better focus on the building speed. But if you're not online that much, it's more important that you can build a lot of warships at the same time rather than the speed. Energy recovery is one of my favorites, I would say, although I haven't done much with it yet. That's just because there are so many attractive things to research. But by having more energy, you can recovering your energy faster. You have more energy every day. That means you can kill more marauders. And for marauders, they're actually a good source of resource income as well. So that's definitely going to be a useful one to focus on. The repair layer optimized and fortify flagship repair. I think for early on I will not do too much on that, because currently I'm not getting into a lot of combat. If you do, definitely this is going to be very useful, but if you don't, yeah, there might be better things to focus on early on. The fast hull sealing is actually one of the very useful projects. If you are an aggressive player, attack a lot, this minimizes the warships you really lose in battle. So more will, instead of being losses, will be converted to severely damaged that you can repair. So that's definitely a very useful stat to increase if you are attacking a lot. So it depends on the kind of gameplay you are doing. The battlefield recycle increases the leadership limit for accepting damaged spaceships, warships. That's definitely also going to be an interesting one. If you are going to be attacked, it's good that you have increased that capacity a lot. And then the dock expansion, that has the same effect, but increases it with a percentage. So those two are definitely going to be useful if you are under attack a lot. And you might research these anyway, already significantly. But yeah, there you have to make choices. But the thing is, you don't know when you're going to be under attack a lot. And if you don't, if you haven't researched these, you might regret it later. One thing about this, there are actually two, so you have a expand dock and dock expansion. That all sounds very similar, while it is it is different. What makes it more complicated that you have two dock expansion, two projects. The first one is actually one of the that is actually a follow-up of the expand dock, so that is going to increase the building queue, so meaning you can build more spaceships or warships at the same time. And the other one is a follow-up on the dock expansion, which is okay, that is the leadership limit, increase the leadership limit for accepting damaged warships in the repair center. So one has got to do with building, the other one with repairing. For military, by far the most important thing in my eyes is the I should at least say that there are two very important things, maybe three. I find unlocking higher tier ships to be very important, and I actually haven't really followed up on that as much as I should, because I didn't realize when I was upgrading my command center to level 16 that actually already at level 16 I can unlock my next tier of warships. So I'm going to put a lot of focus on that now. One of the problems, sorry for I closed that a bit too fast, one of the problems for this the first one, for the first couple of tiers, you only have to research the general combat projects until level 1, but when you get further, starting from tier 5, you have to research the previous project to the max. That's really quite tough to go through level 5. Resource requirements are also already quite steep, but to go to level 5 of those previous projects is also going to be tough, and I'm just starting with level 1 of this Frigate Firepower Boost 2, so that's going to take me quite some time to have all of them done. Frigate is the one I'm going to focus on first, because that is part of the manual, or whatever it's called, the missions. No, shouldn't use the word missions, but the storyline at your left bottom of the screen, where you have to complete certain things. I think building a couple of these warships is my next task there. So that is a very important one. The other one that is very important is the adding expedition queues. So having extra expedition queues, it can be nice for some combat events, but it's very nice because you can just do more gathering resources at the same time. So definitely, if you can unlock these, also put focus on it. And this tree is actually, there's not much choice, because once you in this level, you still don't have to max for this defense, but here the shield I had to maximize, and this firepower I have to maximize before unlocking. So basically you have to maximize everything from here onwards, so that except for these ones, the navigation speed. So this is one you can skip for now. Skipping means just doing the first level, but they are still quite useful as well. So it's all choices, but definitely if you have enough time, they are useful as well to go faster. Well, I shouldn't have closed that yet. The last tree we are going to have a look at is the command tree. This is one, if there is any of these three that is less important of these trees, then it's this one. The project that I do find very nice is the Art of Command, which increases the fleet leadership limit, so meaning you can have more warships in your fleets. So that's of course definitely going to be very nice, but for the rest they're good, but not that good. I think improving your flagship is nice as well, but not as nice as improving your warships in my eyes. I am going to put some focus on this as well, but it's just you have to make choices, and I would prefer to improve my warships. The defenses are also nice, but the spaceport defense being allowed to have more spaceport defenses systems and improving their stats is definitely going to be nice as well. But yeah, you have to make choices. The thing is, you have to work through it to get to the Art of Command 2, and that's another 1,000, so definitely in my eyes worth it to focus on as well. Okay, that's it for the projects here, and hopefully giving you some ideas what to focus on and what's the importance of the various projects. One other thing I want to look at is the research speed. So we already saw in the development category the cloud computing projects. That's going to give you 9% that I have already, so 10%, and there are at least two of them in there, the other one further down the tree, but that's going to be very useful. And so what we also have done what we also have done is for our alliance in the territory, we have certain platforms that give a benefit in research speed, and that is 11%. That is quite a large amount as well. You also have an energy recovering one, also interesting, but that's definitely something to consider and use that you what I'm interested in now, while I'm looking at this currently, I'm not in our alliance territory, so I'm not completely sure whether this buff is actually active. Maybe something to pay attention to. Can I check that? Yes, I can. Currently, I teleported to another area. Yeah, it's still active. I teleported to another area because that's where we are going to do an event later today. So that's the reason. So that's another 11%. Definitely very nice. Another quite large amount. I've been very focused on development. That's definitely going to hurt me with doing combat. But I like to focus on development. And I have a couple of projects, like 10% here in the research speed and another 5% here, so 15. That is definitely very useful as well. So something to consider. I mean, I can really do a lot more research without having to spend speed ups. So that is worth it. There is in Alliance Tech, and I'm not really sure whether this is actually a good thing to focus on, but in the production category, there is actually a research speed project that gives you 0.5% per level. So another, we just have 1% here, but it could go until 10%, but that's a lot of research that needs to be done. But that is something to consider as well. I think there might be more interesting things to do in Alliance research, but that falls a bit outside of the scope. This video is more about the personal research and how we can improve the speed. So that's another one. And finally, what I want to have a look at is the crew. I'm not yet, this was a rapid mining one. I know that I have a research, but I don't know my ear. Kobayakawa. It's just 1.8%, but I like to assign that crew to get an extra research. And looking at the trees, I also have decided to focus most of my effort from the command tree to research initially. So that's another 7.2%. So I have a total of 45. I'm sure you can get much higher, but for a starter, I'm not unhappy about this 45%. Now, it might be that you know of other ways to increase the research speed, and I always am looking for those. So I'm much appreciated if you can share if you have any additional ideas, because that was it for me. One thing I want to show is something else outside of the game, is on my website, gamesguideinfo.com. I have, I'm currently still collecting the data, of course, because I haven't completed the game yet, but I have this tool that can help you in making decisions on what to research. The most beneficial of this tool at this moment in my eyes is that you can quickly see like what research projects are currently unlocked. So this is showing a list based on the research you have done and the level of your research center. And then you can see, okay, what have I, maybe you know you're going to be away for a long time. You think, okay, tonight I want to start this 14-hour development multi-star system probe. Oh, for that I need quite some nickel steel, so I'm going to focus on getting some nickel steel, for example. Or you focus on other, maybe you focus on other things. I might go for the Art of Command, actually, for which I don't need anything special. But you can do, or you know, I'm going to be online. Maybe this is I'm going to be online for quite some hours. Maybe this is a good time to do some smaller projects. That can be the case as well. So if you know many of your alliance mates are online, you can actually quite quickly work through these. So that might be a good moment to work on those. You can here fill in what are your building levels, and if you start with the tool while you have already played, it might be good to just click on these selections to indicate how much of those research projects you have already completed. And I find this personally a very nice tool. And I'm not just saying that because I developed it. I'm using it myself as well for this game and other similar games. Okay, that was it what I wanted to say about the research in Infinite Galaxy. If you have any suggestions, any comments, any questions, that is always much appreciated. And thanks for watching this video.